Columbia, Missouri, as we finish out the SEC Gymnastics regular season inside the Herd Center with Arkansas and Missouri. Last time these teams met, the Tigers set their program record with a 197.85. Similar fireworks could very well be in store tonight. Here are the standings going into the SEC Championships in a few weeks. You have to be in the top four in order to be in the evening session. You can see right now, Arkansas and Missouri are the first two teams out and looking to better that coming up here tonight. With Kennedy Baker, I'm Alex Perlman. So great to see you again as well. And Kennedy, we've gotten to the point in the season where both of these teams now starting to hone in on their routines, their scoring, as we get much, much closer here to the championships.
Absolutely, Alex. Both of these teams are in their last SEC meet of the season, and they're not even trying to compete and beat the team across from them. They're trying to beat themselves to contribute to their NQS score for regionals later this year.
Yeah, there is no question that that is going to be a focus. And these are two teams that are so similar. Well, you don't have to trust me because the numbers back it up. Look at this. I mean, number 12 and number 13 in the rankings. Arkansas leads Missouri by only 0.01. Absolutely microscopic when you talk about the season NQS. They're both absolutely dazzling on floor and separated by one in terms of the ranking as well. But beam has been the Achilles heel for both of these teams. Figure that out, and maybe one of these teams could make a deep run in the postseason. It's really been a transcendent season for Jordan Weber in her fifth year with Arkansas. The expectations are sky high, and because of the gymnasts that they have out there competing, and certainly Maddie Jones has been one of those features for the Razorbacks.
Maddie Jones has been stellar for this Arkansas team, competing on three events. She has had some issues, though, with beam this season, especially last week. Had some struggles on her series, looking to step up a little bit later in the competition today on that event specifically. Also, another rock star for Missouri is Amari Celestine, another three-eventer for their team. Also struggled on beam last week at Auburn. So she's looking to really dial in on these landings and nail the beam routine later this week, later today.
Missouri and Arkansas are looking for fantastic meets here to close out the SEC regular season. They are similar, they are both exceptional, and we are about to see who is going to get the better of who in this rivalry. Tigers, Gymbacks, coming up next. Great atmosphere here inside the Herd Center for number 12 Arkansas and 13th ranked Missouri as we are just moments away from first vault here in Columbia. Here is how a dual meet works in NCAA gymnastics. Six gymnasts per team compete in all four events. The best five scores count, so that's important. You do get one mistake. The lowest score is dropped. Team with the highest cumulative score wins when it's all said and done. And for the home team, that's Missouri this afternoon. Vault, bars, beam, and floor is the order, also known as Olympic order. Year number 11 for Shannon Welker, the 2022 SEC Coach of the Year, taking them to the number 5 overall ranking when it was all finished in NCAA Nationals. And he has built this into now what is really a powerhouse program that can compete with anybody here in the SEC. And we mentioned that Jordan Weber has Arkansas absolutely rolling. They're coming off their highest ranked win in 8 years when they took down number 6 Kentucky, a team that, by the way, earlier today scored their first 198 in program history. So it just shows you the ability that the Gymbacks have this year. They set their program record on floor against Kentucky with a 49.675. Again, that's the strength of both of these teams. Does that cancel each other out, Kennedy? And then is beam going to be the deciding factor, as a lot of times we often see?
I agree with you, Alex. I think tonight is battle of the beam. I think it's going to come down to getting the landings throughout the rotations, and then especially on beam, because that's where both of these teams really need to step up.
Missouri starts on vault where they're ranked 11th in the country. Sienna Schreiber to start her all-around night.
Leading with that round-off back handspring, full twist off the table. Great landing. She stuck one in the warm-up. I'd love to see her implement that again for the competition. Great way to start the rotation for Missouri.
It was a really strong vault rotation last week as well because they dropped her 9-8, which led off the rotation. That just tells you the types of scores that Missouri's capable of putting up. Arkansas's fantastic on bars, though. This is the 10th ranked team in the country on this event. Jordan Weber told us every meet it's a challenge to just see how good we can be. They should be continually between a 49-4 and a 49-5 at worst. And Callie Swaney will lead off a 9-8-5 last week.
Callie opens with a huge ray. That's that release move you saw right there. Beautiful amplitude over the bar. Straight down to a release move. That's called a pack salto. Nice control on that pirouette. You can tell she had to save it a little bit, but landed right on top of the bar. That's exactly what the judges want to see in the handstands. Fought to get that double layout landing. Feet in front of her too much. Had to take that hop back. Taking another look at this release move. So much flight over the bar. A little short on that handstand, though, afterwards. The judges really want to see you all the way vertically on top of the bar from your toes down to your hands.
Sienna Schreiber's score, 9-8-7-5 to start off. Excellent work by the grad student. And now here's the freshman, Raina Light.
Same vault that we saw Sienna do. Yurchenko full, had that hop back. The judges would rather see too much power taking a hop back versus a hop forwards, which shows there was a lack of power.
Now, what are the judges looking for here on bars with Arkansas going?
The judges are looking for the handstands. Are they vertically on top of the bar in one straight line? Releases. What flight are they getting when they let go of the bar, and how high up are they? Dismount, did they nail it? Did their feet find the ground?
Jamie Pratt to follow up Callie Swaney's 9-7-5 to lead off.
Beautiful transition down to the low bar. That shoot over was right to handstand, exactly what the judges want to see. Nice fight for that dismount. Shoulders too far leaned back. That's why she took that little shuffle back. But you want to see the athletes really fight for the landings. And that's exactly what Jamie did. Nice job on that shoot over. Went right to handstand.
Grace Ann Davis. Now, this is Kennedy Griffin, isn't it? This is Kennedy Griffin in there. She has a 10-0 start value, but executes it very well there on the Yurchenko full.
Like you said, Alex, she has a 10-0 start value vault that she is capable of doing today. She played it safe. She stayed with the 9-9-5 Yurchenko full, and it was a good call.
And a lot of times, Kennedy, coaches are weighing what's going to give us the most scoring potential. Yes, you started a 9-9-5 value with a Yurchenko full, but if you can stick it, you might get a higher score than you get on a 10-0 start value.
Correct. Sometimes it's better to play it safe with a lower start value and get closer to getting the landing than risk it with a 10-0 start value.
This is Reese Drotar following up a 9-7-5 and a 9-8.
Reese has stunning lines on bars. I love how she held that handstand for a clear second, indicating to the judges she is on top of that bar. Fought to get that landing. They are going to take a deduction for that chest down at the end, but you could tell she tried to hold it and really save it. I like the effort. I mean, they are going to take a deduction, though, with that chest at the end. Dug those toes in.
Is that better than taking a step, though, in the judge's mind?
Maybe. That's a good question.
Really
I
know,
think that I'd have to think about that.
Here's the freshman Hannah Horton.
Their first Yurchenko, 1.5 twists. That's a 10-0 start value vault, like we mentioned earlier. Had way too much power off of the table. Took a really big hop there. You can tell she tried to dig those toes into the ground. Unfortunately, had too much pop off of the table. Again, you would rather see too much, though, than less.
Serena Linton, the grad student, transferred in from Arizona before the year. Just her third bars routine this year. Her last came 2 weeks ago, where she scored a 9.675. At the moment, they're dropping a 9.75 from Sweeney.
Serena has done a great job in this fifth-year role, stepping up, helping mentor the freshmen and the younger athletes. Nailed that last landing.
I think she might have heard
that
herself.
That is a perfect stick.
Another chance, right, next week?
Right.
That was awesome.
Beautiful. That you want to be in that green area within 10 degrees in your handstands to not get a deduction. Right to the stick. Her chest is up. Great posture coming out. Excellent job from Serena.
Very consistent for Missouri so far. Three straight 9.825s following Schreiber's 9.875, the highest score at the moment. But Amari Celestine can go way higher than that.
Oh, power off the table, took that step forward. She stuck two in the warm-up. I know she wanted to find this landing when she competed. The height she gets off of the table, though, I would like to emphasize, too, that is a blind landing. That means when the gymnasts are coming down out of their skills, landing forwards, they cannot see where their feet are landing, making it more challenging as well than the Yurchenko full because it doesn't have a blind landing.
Jensen Scalzo follows up Serena Linton's career high 9.9. That's the exact same score that Jensen got last week.
Looking to get this last landing here. Beautiful double layout. Piped it down a little bit. That's why her feet landed in front. Took that little scoop, step back. Beautiful release move there. That's called a Jaeger directly down to her transition to the low bar. Usually when you do your transition, you want to get all the way up to handstand. Since she connects it from her high bar release, she gets a 10th and bonus and doesn't have to go vertically all the way to handstand.
It's Jensen's only event, her 42nd career bars routine tonight. And now Jocelyn Moore, the reigning SEC vault champion.
Oh, tried a little too hard to find that landing. Took that step back. Lost some block a little bit off of the table. You can tell she turned a little early. Usually she waits longer before she starts twisting off of the table.
Should end up being a solid vault rotation here for Missouri. At the moment, they can drop one of those three 9.825s. Amari Celestine's score was a 9.875. And now Maddie Jones will finish up trying to get rid of Callie Sweeney's 9.75.
I watched her in the warm-up, Alex, and I will say she struggled a little bit in the warm-up, especially with that release move right there. And she also struggled with that pack salto a little bit in the warm-up as well. You could tell even on that one, the shoulders were closed too far over the bar. Great job saving it, though, to finish up the routine here. Just the dismount left.
Solid.
Excellent. Stunning dismount right there. Had to battle through that routine a little bit. Glad she got to get that dismount, though, at the end. You'll see right here, her shoulders are a little too far over on top of the bar. You want them slightly pulled back when you catch and turned out a handstand on that pirouette. Like I said, the judges want to see you right on top of the bar. Found that dismount, though. Great way to close the event for Arkansas.
Arkansas needs a 9.875 from Maddie Jones to take the lead after one rotation. A solid vault rotation for Missouri, and we'll see on Arkansas's final score. Well, we've talked about NQS national qualifying score so much over the last couple weeks. We'll break it down and tell you how it all works when we come back. Close as we thought it would be after one rotation. These two teams separated by just 0.75. This should be a tight race down the stretch as we continue here into the second rotation. Well, we've heard a lot about NQS, as we mentioned. What is it? It's used to determine team or individual's positions in NCAA postseason. These are the rankings in college gymnastics. How do you get it? You identify the six highest scores. Three of those have to come away from home. You drop the highest score and then average the remaining five to get your NQS. Alex and Kennedy back with you. And Kennedy, I mean, you know, as a gymnast, some love to know what the NQS is that they're shooting for. Some don't really care. They just want to go out and do their best routine. What was the way that you approached it?
I approached it, I cared. And even if they don't care, I know it's in the back of their minds, constantly thinking about how they can contribute their scores tonight and the rest of the regular season for the postseason. Regional seedings, so important.
Well, why don't we show you how Arkansas's NQS was calculated here going into this week? Well, you identify again, there's six top scores. There they are. Three of them are on the road, so that requirement is satisfied. Now what do? Well, we take away the highest score. So you throw out that season high 197.525. You take the remaining five, average them together, and you get their NQS currently at 197.19. Now, the number to keep in mind for tonight is 196.8. If Arkansas scores better than that, they will drop that lowest score and their NQS will increase because of it. So you know that head coach Jordan Weber has that in the back of her mind. And then coming up, a couple of chances at home, because let's be honest, doesn't have to be on the road for you to get a better NQS. And then, of course, the SEC championships to come March 23rd. Kennedy, that does count when you talk about NCAA rankings going into regionals.
Absolutely. And considering that SEC's is their last technically road score, they're going to want to have a lights out competition at the SEC championships as well.
Well, we still have so much more to do with three rotations left. In the second, Arkansas will head to vault at Missouri to bars here inside the Hearn Center. Just 0.75 separating Arkansas and Missouri, with the Gymbacks taking the lead after one rotation. The highlight, certainly Serena Linton, the fifth-year grad student, transfer from Arizona, the highlight. Arkansas to vault, and Cammie Weaver leads off.
Huge Yurchenko full for Cammie. So much power, took that big hop backwards. They really want to start finding these landings if they want to keep that lead.
Set a new career high with a 9.925 to lead off last week's meet. And now Missouri heads to bars. Shannon Welker told us that he wanted a little bit more in terms of the stick department last week, where they had a 49.225. And Kira Burns leads off. This is a rotation that is ranked number 13 in the country.
And speaking of stuck landings, last week Kira stuck her dismount, looking to build off of that energy and do the same exact thing this week, so the rest of the rotation can finish out strong.
She's competed bars the last 14 meets and has put up a 9.8 or better in each one. It certainly makes sense that Shannon slid her into the top spot a month ago.
It's starts with a nice Jaeger straight down to her release move. Like I mentioned earlier, she doesn't have to go vertical all the way to handstand on that transition down. Wow. Excellent start for Missouri on bars. Nailed that last dismount. You can see her feet found the floor, eyeballs were glued down, and landed with her chest up. Exactly the momentum you want going into your double layout dismount.
She certainly held it for that 1 second that is necessary with the new stick rule this year. Leah Smith, speaking of sticks, did that with her vault last week with a 9-9. Two in a row.
Back to back, Alex. You love to see it. So consistent on this vault, especially. Dug those toes into the ground. Little movement in that arm circle. Fought through it though. Nice effort from Leah.
We'll see Leah on floor coming up. One of the most electric rotations in the country. But Holland Patrick now, the grad student from Colorado. 9.825 last week and following up the 9.9. Excellent career high score from Kira Burns to lead off.
Kira did a great job starting this event for Missouri. I know the team's working on building off of that energy throughout the rest of the lineup. Great job getting that handstand all the way up before a transition down to the low bar. Beautiful, huge dismount and very nice routine from Holland. Her legs are side by side in that dismount. Incredibly impressive. Usually people have a small straddle in between. Really appreciate how she glues her legs and keeps them all the way together.
Frankie Price now, the redshirt sophomore from Dallas, all SEC on vault last year.
Frankie tried to find that landing, had a small hop back. Small deduction on that hop back, but should be a solid score for her.
Strong rotation so far, 9-8 for Weaver, 9-8-5 for Smith. And now Amaya Marshall. She is replacing Hannah Horton in the lineup as a late scratch. They moved Holland Patrick from number 3 to number 2, and Marshall has been inserted into the third spot.
Amaya opening with a huge Jaeger straight down to a release move on the low bar. Fighting to get these handstands all the way up.
She just goes into the ceiling on that release. I'm surprised she doesn't fly out of the building. All right,
she
well,
does.
Let's take a look at the points of emphasis what the judges are looking for here on vault, Kennedy.
Start value. Like we mentioned earlier, some vaults start from a 10, some from a 9.95. Execution, what does their form look like in the air? How pointed are their toes? How straight are their legs? And of course, the landing. Did they dial it in, or did they take a step or a hop? Arkansas's first Yurchenko 1.5. Landed legs really straight. When you come into the floor, you want your knees slightly bent to cushion that impact on your body. And you'll see she just missed that spot coming in. Overestimated it.
So that's just her fourth collegiate vault as well. And now Sienna Schreiber coming off back-to-back 9.9s. This is a massive rotation so far. Nothing below a 9.9 at the moment here from Missouri.
Sienna is just such a rock for this Missouri team. Didn't get that last landing. Feet too far behind her, but really solid routine and great work from Sienna. Stunning handstand right on top of the bar. Precisely what the judges want to see. And you'll see this double layout. Anticipated it a little too early. Had those shoulders in front. Otherwise, great
work. She has just meant so much to this Missouri program now in her final season. Haley Klein, just a freshman, 9.825 last week for Arkansas in vault.
Big power off of the table from Haley.
And here comes that vault. Jocelyn Moore. Let's get to know her a little bit, what she loves to do out there competing.
My favorite skill is my takatch of bail on bars. I love it because it just feels like I'm in the air flying and I'm catching the bar with my hands, which is pretty abnormal. So I like to do it and it's just cool to feel, a cool feeling.
And we are in for such a treat with Jocelyn. Starts with a gigantic release move. So much flight over the bar.
There it is.
I mentioned earlier, she doesn't have to get that handstand all the way up, but wow, she was pretty close anyways. Full twisting double touch straight to the stick.
Just planted that.
A lot of flight off of that bar. The way she pops and rises is incredibly impressive. And again, you can see she finds the landing, holds on to it. Your feet are allowed to be shoulder width apart, so there shouldn't be a deduction right there for that stick. Nice work for Jocelyn.
Should be a big score. And now Lauren Williams to anchor Arkansas on vault. At the moment, they're dropping one of their 9.8s. She's capable of a huge score.
Power off of the table, had that shuffle in front. Arkansas is going to have to start nailing these landings, though, if they want to stay in the race with Mizzou.
Lauren qualified for nationals on vault last year, and now here's a pretty special competitor, Mara Titar-Soli out of the Netherlands, the LIU transfer, a perfect 10 for her in the anchor spot 2 weeks ago. First for Missouri ever on bars, but it was actually the second of Mara's storied career.
Mara is...
Wow.
Unfortunately, that's going to be a 5/10 in deduction right there. Out of the release, she got a lot of height, but her hands didn't get all the way over the bar. If your hand and your grip and fingers aren't on top of the bar, unfortunately, you're going to have that slip back that you just saw right there from Mara.
Look, this is not a killer by any means for Missouri. At the moment, they're dropping a 9.85, so that 9.85 will just count. And whatever this score comes in from Titar-Soli is going to be dropped. This is still a huge rotation on bars for Missouri.
It is, Alex. They're absolutely still in this competition. Nice fight on that dismount. It's hard to really pick up the energy after you fall in the middle of your routine. You have to get back up there. And you'll see her fingers just weren't all the way on top of the bar. She barely got her hands to the bar and unfortunately had that fall back. I'm glad she landed safely, though.
And we are joined by Arkansas head coach Jordan Weber. All right, Jordan, we're halfway home at this point. Strong vault rotation. You guys just seem to be really coming on at the end of the year. What do you think of the competition so far?
I think it's going great so far. Obviously, we're hitting. We're doing really strong routines. We've got to settle into some landings a little bit more. But floor is one of our best events, so I'm really excited for this next rotation.
Jordan, we spoke earlier this week. You said the team is starting to really dial in and understand their potential. With that in mind, what is your goal in this next rotation to really live up to that potential?
I want to see their confidence. I mean, we see it every day in the gym. We're starting to see it consistently in competition. So I really want to see them shine, perform, really go for those strong landings, and just see overall confidence from the team.
Well, we certainly know how good you guys are in floor, and we can't wait to see it. Jordan, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Well, we are in the midst of floor royalty with multiple floor queens here between Arkansas and Missouri coming up. They'll tell you in their own words what they love so much about performing out on the floor.
Hi, I'm here with Frankie Pice, Jocelyn Moore, and Lauren Williams. We are talking floor routines.
What makes a floor routine great is entertaining the crowd. I remember going to meets when I was younger, and if the routine entertained me, I was all in, and that's what made me want to come back. When I'm on the floor performing, I like to engage the crowd, look them in the eyes, and make them feel like they are seen so that they want to come back.
Do you guys have a favorite part of your routine that you love performing the most?
I would say for my floor routine, the worm. I had it last year and I kept it this year. And I think whether for home or away, everyone in the crowd always goes crazy. I think that's really fun and unique in my routine that's different from all the others.
Mine is definitely Freddy Doll. It's just a super fun song that mostly everyone knows. And when they hear it, they're like, oh my gosh, she has like Snoop Dogg in her floor routine. So it's super fun.
All three of you have come so close to a 10. What is going through your head when you see a judge flash a 10?
I think that's such an exciting thing to be able to experience, knowing that I am so close to perfection, but just each day in the gym, going through each details and making sure I'm staying in the present.
Thank you guys so much. I will be chanting 10 from the booth, rooting for all of you guys.
Jocelyn Moore, Lauren Williams, and Frankie Pice are all just worth the price of admission on their own. All of them in the top eight. Look at those massive NQSs this season, and we can't wait. You see Williams and Pice coming up in the third rotation. The final one is when Jocelyn Moore will steal the show. And we can't talk about floor queens without showing some love to our very own Kennedy. How about your third career 10 on floor? What do you remember from that routine?
I remember going into that routine feeling like I was going to get a 10. If you have that confidence ahead of time, usually you can carry it throughout the routine. So hopefully we can see that from those three tonight.
I mean, I would definitely take a 10. That would be awesome. We've seen plenty throughout the day with Florida and Kentucky as well. All right, we've got two more rotations to go. Arkansas will go to floor. You don't want to miss them. They're one of the top teams in the country. And Missouri to try to hold the lead on beam. Through the first two rotations, Missouri holding on to a 0.125 lead right now over Arkansas. But the question is, will they be able to keep it because the Tigers head to beam? Well, it's also alumni night here inside the Hearn Center, and Elisa Sharametta certainly knows something about being able to compete on beam. 11 career 9-9s, you see her there towards the bottom of your screen. And hoping that they're able to channel some Elisa Sharametta energy, Kennedy, because this is a team that's really struggled on beam. Shannon Welker told us that they're capable of more. Last week, just a 48-9-7-5, and they were forced to count three scores below 9-8.
Correct, Alex. This is going to be a big test for this Missouri team on beam. They've been focusing so much on in practice on this event specifically, and there's been so many times this season alone that they've gone into beam in the lead and lost that lead because of beam.
Grace Ann Davis has the chance to lead off. That's exactly what happened against Auburn. They had the advantage heading into the last rotation, but then Auburn took it right away with a very strong floor. Davis is in the leadoff spot this week, moving all the way up.
Yeah, Alex, they've switched this beam lineup a couple times this season. Definitely switched it from last week tonight. Nice job on that acro series. Starts with a handspring layout step out, a requirement for everybody in their beam routine. Nice save there. That's called a front toss. That's a front tuck off of one foot. She was off to the side, missed that foot, balance corrected, shifted those shoulders, and stayed on the beam. Impressive effort.
That was a pretty assertive save, too.
It was. Something I'm sure they really focused on in practice, along with beam routines and just getting beam more secured, is confidence. Beautiful gainerful off the side, right to the stick. Honestly, great start for Missouri. Really good effort here from Grace Ann. Wow, you could tell that foot was off to the side and she had to fix her shoulders in the middle of it to swing herself back onto the beam. Nicely done there.
All right, here's Arkansas on floor, coming off of a new program record, 49-6-7-5 last week in their win over Kentucky. Ended with four scores of 9-9-2-5 or better as Calista Gamyau gets us underway, the junior from Honolulu.
Great flight on that opening tumbling run. That's called a double pike. Calista does a great job starting off this event for Arkansas. One and a half through to double full. Step back into the lunge. Great job there. I liked it a couple weeks ago. She had so much control over that pass. She actually didn't step back into the lunge. She stuck. Feet glued together. It's not a deduction, stepping back into the lunge. But it's just more impressive that if they can land with their feet together. Setting up for this final tumbling pass here. Double tuck, similar to her first pass, but with her legs in the tuck position instead of straight. And you'll notice on that lunge, she had too much power. They might take a half a tenth or a quarter of a tenth off there because she showed a little less control stepping back. Nice way to start the rotation, though, for Arkansas.
Really solid. And now on beam, Raina Light with Grace Ann Davis scoring a 9-8. That save might end up being the difference in the meet. That's how close these teams are. And what are the judges looking for?
They're looking at the dance and acro skills. Are they meeting all the requirements necessary for their beam routine? Connections. Is everything flowing together as one? And of course, the skills. What are they doing? And are they doing it to the stick?
Raina 9.775 last week. She just entered the beam lineup about a month ago.
Raina starts here with an incredibly difficult triple series. You could tell, actually, she was off on the first two back handsprings, fought to get that back on the beam. And talking with head coach Shannon Welker earlier this week, she is very consistent for this team. He knows when he puts her in lineup, she's going to hit. It's just a matter of how well.
Thank you.
just the dismount left here for Reyna. Cat leap through to Gaynor Pike. Shoulders lean forward when she took off and on the landing, had her feet back too much, had to take that step forward.
Both teams with 9-8s to start out as we wait on that score for Reyna Light. And now the judges' points of emphasis here for Florida.
The difficulty. How hard are their passes, the presentation? Are they selling their choreography? Are they playing it up? And of course, the landings. How much are they dialing it in when they come down from their passes?
Haley Klein tied her career high with a 9.875 last week, just like Gamyao did with that same score. Haley learned this first pass only just before the season.
Super difficult when you train one pass and you have to switch it to another. Beautiful front layout through to double tuck. I enjoy Haley's front layout step out that you saw before she did that double tuck a lot because her legs are so straight. Sometimes people bend it a little bit when they come down to the floor. She keeps her legs completely tight. Double pike, fought to stay in bounds. Those white lines on the mat are an indication to the judges whether or not they're within the floor or outside of it. If you take a step outside, it is a deduction.
On the line, okay. Outside the line, 10th deduction.
Nice effort from Haley. Looking at this double pike, had a lot of power coming out.
Definitely
stayed in that corner. Yep.
And so no deduction there. And again, following up the 9-8 from Gamyao for Arkansas. Now Davis and Light starting off with a 9-8 and a 9.725 respectively for Missouri on beam. And now there is certainly some pressure on Sydney Schaefer's shoulders, who had a 9.7 last week.
Yeah, like you mentioned, Alex, Sydney struggled on this series coming up right here last week, almost fell against Auburn. Great job on it today, though. A little soft in that back leg, right to the lunge, though.
You feel like, Kennedy, at this point in the season, though, you really want to develop confidence on this event. And Missouri is unfortunately running out of opportunities to do that with only a few meets remaining before postseason.
Right, Alex. And like we talked about with Shannon, that is what it is. He knows that this team has so much potential on this event. But if their confidence isn't there, they're not going to rise up to that potential. And that's really where you're seeing these little mistakes here. They're battling through, but it's a lack of confidence in the skill, not a lack of capability in doing the skill. Great effort on that dismount, though. We talked about it earlier. That's a blind landing, so she can't see her feet coming down to the mat. Has to feel it in the air.
Wednesday, the SEC Women's DC Now Crew. South Carolina won today, perfect 16-0. Who is going to beat Dawn Staley's team? I mean, they're now 29-0 this season. I don't know. I don't see it, but that's why they play the games, especially once you get to the NCAA tournament. Here's Maddie Jones. She started the string of four straight 9.925 plus scores to close out the rotation last week with a career high 9.925.
Maddie is really fun to watch on all events, especially on floor. She opens with one of my favorite tumbling passes that you just saw right there, her front double twist. is incredibly good. Her legs are always glued together in the air. One and a half front layout right here. Straight to the choreography. Excellent control coming out of that pass. It's challenging to compete on all events, especially beam and floor on the road. Really have to rely on your teammates and use their energy. You see them on the side doing their choreography with her. Very nice job. That's called a front Rudy. That's a front one and a half twist. You can tell her teammates are super excited about their routine, as they should be. Here's that front double twist that I love. Her legs are so close together in the air. Sometimes you see people cross their legs. She never does. Right to the choreography, and I love how you can see her teammates hyping her up on the side. You need that energy, though, when you're on the road especially.
Now, Arkansas might have gone through a bit of a mid-season lull where their scores weren't what Jordan Weber was hoping for, but, I mean, 3 meets in 7 days recently kind of, like, seemed to rejuvenate them almost competing that much. And you can tell they're starting to click on all cylinders once again. There are the scores, hoping to drop Raina Lights 9-7-2-5, but it's going to be up to Amaya Marshall right here.
We've talked about it throughout this Missouri lineup on beam. Amaya has a lot of confidence going into this event, which is exactly what you need, especially following up some mistakes. A little off that beam to the right side. Great job correcting it, though, and bringing it back. Finds the landing on that gainer full. They're going to take a deduction on that front toss that she did.
Remember, though, that, you know, Arkansas really would love to have the lead. They were trailing by 0.175 after two rotations. Heading into the fourth, they would love to be ahead of Missouri to put themselves in the best spot to win this meet, because they're not exactly lights out on beam either. They've struggled in that just like Missouri has, and we know that the Tigers are so strong on floor to close it out. So is Leah Smith, obviously. 9.925 last week. Has gone as high as 9.95 and capable maybe even higher than that, following up the 9.925 Jones.
Stunning double tuck stuck. And these last three for Arkansas, Leah, Lauren, and Frankie, are just really a triple threat. Their performance quality has gone up every single year. And they really build off of each other well in this lineup, making it easier to really find flight in their tumbling and play up their choreography for the crowd and their teammates.
Couldn't really ask for a much better final three. I mean, there are some really good ones around the country, but Smith, Williams, and Price are right up there with anyone else.
Fought to get that landing, tried to find it and get that stick, a little shuffle forward. Nice hide off the floor, though, and great routine from Leah.
So at the moment, still dropping that 9-8 from Gagnon.
I really like how Leah finds this landing out of the double tuck with her chest up. Great posture there. She fought to find this landing right here. You can see when she comes into the floor, she's spotting it. Just had to take that small hop forward.
And it's such an exciting future on floor coming up too, because all three of those athletes that we mentioned are sophomores. Frankie Price, a redshirt sophomore, but she still has the same amount of eligibility as the other two do as well. Amari Celestine, the junior, fell in the leadoff spot to start the final rotation last week, and now she has been dropped down in the lineup to number 5 ahead of Sienna Schreiber.
There's her acro series right there. Back handspring step out through to side aerial. Very well done. And this is really about confidence for Amari. We've mentioned it a lot, but it just is really what beam boils down to. How you feel up there. You have to feel like you know exactly what you're doing when you get up on the beam. That is where Amari had the mistake last week, but not today. Beautiful job right there. And I love how on her splits, she is at and above that 180 degrees. No deductions from the judges right there. Wow. So solid for Amari. She should be proud of that routine. That was really great.
As well, you know that she's feeling great after that routine.
And she should. Coach Shannon Welker mentioned the confidence he has in Amari. But they've really had to kind of challenge her with this season being her first time in the beam lineup to step up and deliver, and that's exactly what she did tonight.
That smile well deserved. Oh, but now she's down on the floor. We'll keep our eyes on that. Lauren Williams. 9.95 for the second straight meet last week. She is one of the floor queens that we highlighted for a reason.
This is a big routine for Arkansas. Lauren, such a joy to watch on floor. You've got to be on the lookout for her favorite part of her routine, the worm, which is coming up shortly.
Kennedy, you ever think about incorporating something like that into yours?
Like a worm or just a fun part?
Like a worm. Where did that even come from? I love it.
I don't think I would have been as graceful as Lauren. I would have looked more like anything else. Maybe like a pencil or something. I don't think my body can do that.
Like a flopping fish.
Yeah.
Not
mine
like
wouldn't
that.
Have looked like that. Yeah, mine would give fish, Alex.
Fish energy.
Final tumbling pass here for Lauren. Double tuck. Huge height. Beautiful landing. No deductions there. Straight to the lunge. Breaking it down.
Now she's calling for the 10.
I did say I was going to be chanting 10 in the booth, so I guess I've got to start as well. This opening pass is huge. The hip rise she gets off of the floor is incredibly impressive. And then a little fun choreography in there.
Gets me every time. Absolutely love it. And that's following up Leah Smith's 9.85. So should be a massive score with just Frankie Price to anchor floor for Arkansas. And now here is the beam queen, Sienna Schreiber. Shared that title with Cassie Stevens of Auburn last meet. The 9.925 tying her career high.
Sienna is a rock for this Missouri team. Specifically on beam. Kept the triple series in this week. Back handspring, layout, step out, layout, step out. Last week she took it out. Glad to see it back in the lineup.
Oh,
lines and extension off of the beam, out of her skills, is really what the judges are looking for. She's so explosive, but so specific. Beautifully done. Nice stick from Sienna. The team is chanting 10 for a reason. And this triple series is more than impressive. It's a clinic in what it's supposed to look like. And then again, stunning gainer full off the side.
It looks like she did it. If that reaction says anything, it's perfection for Sienna Schreiber. Look at that. Schreiber's first ever 10-0 on beam.
What a stunning routine for Sienna.
It really was, wasn't it? So deserving. Well, that was the first 10 on beam for Missouri gymnasts since 2004. But look, I don't want to speak too soon, but Frankie Price has a chance to repeat in back-to-back routines here. That's just how good she is on floor for Arkansas.
Frankie opening with that gigantic double layout you saw. Really can show off her power on this event, as well as her dance.
Last week tied her career high with a 9.975, got a 10 from one judge. So I'm telling you, it's not out of the question.
Final pass here. Front full through to front layout. Finds the landing coming out of it.
She's pretty automatic.
She is excited about that one. The team's chanting 10, and she should be excited. That was a nice routine from Frankie. This pass is big. Double layout, spots her feet coming in, goes right into the lunge. And again, front layout spots the corner coming out, straight into the finish position.
So huge there for Missouri to get the 10-0 from Sienna Schreiber, because it drops the 9.725 from Raina Light. And I'm telling you, Grace Ann Davis saving that beam routine in the leadoff spot, again, could very well be the difference in this meet. We're just waiting on Frankie Price's score to come in, but it took a little while, but now we've certainly heated up here inside Columbia. Well, let's bring in the Missouri head coach, Shannon Welker. Shannon.
Yes, sir.
Sienna, finally. I mean, she's been deserving of it for years.
Yep.
And rewarded with that 10-0. What did you see from your vantage
awesome.
Point?
So she just aggressive. It was so great to see her finally rewarded. Like you just said, I think she's done a number of 10-0s before, but it was great to see it happen tonight. The clock was ticking on that one, so.
Last week on the road, Coach Shannon, you had an excellent showing on floor with your team. How are you taking that energy from the last meet and adding to it for this last rotation at home?
Yeah, I think just having some fun and we just go over there and enjoy it and remind them use their cues and just breathe and just, have fun with it and really enjoy this crowd that's in here. We got one more home meet after this, but we're going to enjoy this one tonight.
Absolutely, Shannon. Go enjoy it and good luck in the fourth rotation.
All right, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Wow, what a meet we have had. That third rotation absolutely lit it up. And Sienna Schreiber, the highlight so far with the 10-0. Her first on beam. Tomorrow night, it's an SEC Inside doubleheader, 7 Eastern, and all access pass to the Auburn men's basketball program, and that's followed by a behind-the-scenes look at the Texas A&M women's basketball team. They're getting set for the SEC tournament right here on the SEC Network and streaming live on the ESPN app. So the final SEC regular season meet coming to a close, sadly, here inside the Hearn Center tonight. But looking at the SEC standings, you've got to be in the top four in order to make the night session, the evening session at SEC Championships. That's LSU, Florida, Kentucky, and Alabama at the moment. Arkansas and Missouri can put together some strong meets, though, at the end of the year and potentially help their NQS. Missouri does better than a 197 tonight. Arkansas does better than a 196.8. And their NQS will improve. But it just seems like no matter what any team in the SEC does, you can't knock off Florida for the SEC regular season title. Kentucky certainly tried to. Mackenzie Wilson, her second career 10-0 on vault. Anya Pilgrim, much deserved, and this will not be the last, but it was her first shot at perfection. I think she's excited. And then Raina Worley, finally this year, the lid has come off the 10-0. And, well, she just got her third career on floor, her fourth ever. And look at that score for Kentucky. 198.1 set their new program record. Kennedy, they had never gone above a 198 before today.
Right. Kentucky is doing such a great job this season. And then, of course, we've got LSU in the second spot, defeating Alabama with a 198.325, the third highest score in program history. And 28th Georgia upsetting number 14 Auburn with a 197.55, the highest score they've gotten since 2019.
There is no doubt that the Gym Dogs are coming on strong, and they might be a dark horse once we get to New Orleans in a few weeks. One more rotation to go, and you don't want to miss Missouri on floor. Arkansas is going to go to the beam with a 10th and a half lead, but that's just about nothing when you talk about one of the best floor rotations in the country coming up next. To the lead, and we're going to the fourth and final rotation. Arkansas has pulled ahead after a very strong floor rotation, leading by a 10th. And a half. Alex Perlman, Kennedy Baker, back with you in Columbia, Missouri. Kennedy, what do both of these teams need to do to pull out a win here tonight?
Yeah, Alex, we've had a great battle back and forth between both teams. However, I will say that Missouri doesn't have the disadvantage of falling completely off of the floor, where Arkansas will be facing that on beam. I know they want to rise to the occasion. That's been their focus all practice this week, so that's really what they're going to dial in and have to do if they want to come out with the win from Missouri.
For head coach Jordan Weber, I mean, last week they did hit all six routines, but counted only one score above 9-8. Solid, not spectacular, and they're looking to reverse this trend here for the Gym Backs, and it starts with the ultra-steady leadoff, Calista Gagne.
Calista does an excellent job of starting this beam rotation for Arkansas, mounting with an incredibly difficult layout, step out, as her acro series, and she sticks it almost every time. It's very impressive. And Calista's just so relaxed up there. Definitely the energy that you want from your starter. Confidence and relaxation. Nice work on that full turn, a requirement for every beam routine. Sometimes the full turn is more difficult than the harder acro elements. Beautifully done, round off 1.5. Nailed that blind landing. Awesome start for Arkansas on beam.
Had a 9-8 last week. That should be even better and keep the pressure on Missouri, because we know we're going to see some big scores towards the end of this lineup. And Sienna Schreiber hasn't exactly had much time to rest following her perfect 10, has she? Well, She led off with a 9.85 last week. Shannon Welker thinks she's just the perfect leadoff because she's just always clean and consistent.
Sienna is really fun to watch on floor. Like you said, Alex, she is so clean in the air. Stunning form throughout her tumbling, especially right there. For this team. Mentoring and helping the underclassmen as well as delivering in her performances. And wow, I love the height of that jump out of that last pass right there. Great lead off for Mizzou. Awesome job from Sienna. Her form in the air is exquisite. Legs glued together, her feet down to her big toe, all the way pointed. Really enjoy the height she gets on that last split jump.
On the beam for Arkansas, Maddie Jones.
Sienna has just had an incredible meet, the only all-arounder competing, but she has excelled in every single event. And now Maddie Jones had a few balance checks. They were able to drop her 9.675 last week. But again, when you know you talk about a Missouri team that's so good on floor, you need to keep hitting. Gamya certainly did with her 9.9.
And this is where she struggled last week against Kentucky, Alex, but not today. Excellent stick. If Maddie can hit this routine, it'll be a great confidence booster for her to get these landings on the road to really help prepare her for the postseason. Nice amplitude on that split jump too. That's called a stag jump. Front pull dismount, line landing here. Nails it, second week in a row, she's got it. Awesome work from Maddie. Really hope she uses this beam routine throughout the rest of the season. That should be a good score. Here's that seer. She struggled with last week against Kentucky. Legs all the way straight throughout the back handsprings. Exactly what the judges want to see. And finds this landing out of her front full to the stick.
Well, you can tell that we are getting close to the postseason because both of these teams are really starting to dial in their routines. Sienna Schreiber tied her career high set earlier this month with a 9.925. And now a late change here for Missouri. The freshman Raina Light subbed in for the veteran Alana Kratzer. What a spot for her.
Alana opening with a whip through to double tuck. Stunning landing there. I love whips. A whip is that back handspring you saw with no hands, though. She does into her pass. Difficult and impressive. Alana always has really cool choreography on floor. I look forward to seeing it every year. Double pike, awesome job. Landed with her chest up. You can see her team getting into it on the side. Alana feeling that energy going into this last tumbling run. One and a half front layout, straight to the choreography. Nicely done.
I think you have to give Alana a lot of credit, too, because she was a mainstay in the Flora lineup last year, competed every single meet. This is only the fourth time that she's done Flora this year. Stayed ready and absolutely slayed this.
Absolutely, Alex. And it's hard to go in lineup when you're not expecting to be in lineup. So Alana did a nice job delivering in this surprise second spot.
So far for Arkansas, a 9-9 for Gamyao, and Maddie Jones with a 9-9-2-5. That's a career high mark. Lauren Williams to finish up her night. Remember, it was only a tenth and a half separating these two teams, a razor-thin margin, but both putting up massive scores here in this fourth rotation.
Lauren, so dynamic on this event. Slight balance check there. They'll take a tenth or half tenth off there.
Remember, you can drop the lowest score.
Beautiful pike front toss. Prepping for this dismount. She got it last week. We're gonna see if she can do it again. Lauren lands facing away from the beam, so she can't see her feet coming in. Good effort from Lauren.
And so far, nothing below a 9-9 on floor for Missouri. Team now home for two straight meets. It's only their third of the season, though. They've had so much time on the road. They already have four road scores of 197 or better. They'd never done that before in program history. And you are seeing why this might be a team to be reckoned with down the stretch. Hannah Horton just over-twisted her final pass. Keep our eye on that, but enjoy the routine up until.
Hannah's routine is definitely a fan favorite. Opens with a big full twisting double tuck. A lot of hip rise out of that. And like you mentioned earlier, Alex, had some twisting troubles last week against Auburn. Really focused on that in practice this week. They went back and actually did some drills, broke it down, half, full, one and a half, double, two and a half. So that's where she's supposed to stop. Here's where she struggled last week. Missed it again this week. You can tell she just got lost in the air. And something that Coach Shannon Welker was saying earlier is that if you, they really focused on keeping her head in. When you take off of the floor, you want your head facing forward, not facing the ceiling. If your eyeballs are looking at the ceiling, it's really hard to know where you're at in the air. You'll see her head's back slightly when she takes off, and she can't find that landing coming out of it.
At this point, Kennedy, when you get down towards the postseason and you really need these scores, do you consider maybe even changing that last pass, even though I know it's really late in the year to do that?
I think that it's something that they will definitely chat about and potentially change, for sure. If she's capable of doing something else. It's hard to change twisting, though, especially if you're already getting a little bit lost in it, to go back to another twist.
All right, well, now Cammie Weaver to follow up the 9-8 from Lauren Williams. That, at the moment, though, is the score that Arkansas is dropping, and they have the lead after the third rotation. Horton's score, whenever it does come in, is clearly going to be the one that Missouri wants to say goodbye to.
Cammie Weaver is so consistent for this Arkansas team on beam. Week after week, hitting incredibly solid and sticking this dismount. She got it last week, and she got it again this week. One and a half twist, has to feel it in the air, digs those toes in and holds on to it. That should be a big score for Arkansas.
This is a stellar beam rotation so far for the Gymbacks, with only Haley Klein and Serena Linton still to go. We wait on Hannah's score to come in. Amari Celestine, you can see already today, a couple of scores, 9.825 or better. Hannah Horton's is a 9.15. So that is the score they are going to again try to drop. The good news, though, for Missouri is that Celestine, Griffin, and Moore are capable of huge scores and just about do it every time. Celestine had a 9.925 last week, already her 21st career score of 9.9 or better.
If there is someone you want coming up after a fall, it is definitely Amari Celestine. Nice full in, a lot of power, a little bigger step to the lunge, but wow, the height she gets off of the floor. Nice job on that second pass right there, straight to the crown choreography. And Amari really eats this choreography. She just plays it up so much, it looks like. She's having the best time out there.
Her brother Artion choreographed it again. This year it's a tribute to HBCUs. Artion, professional dancer, was on Dancing with the Stars Junior.
Last pass, big double tuck. Great way to close and bounce back for Amari in the lineup, building up that energy again. Did a great job setting up her teammates there. The hip rise. She is so high up there. Fights to stay in bounds in that lunge. And giving us some fun choreo moments.
And so that kind of resets the atmosphere in a lot of ways, with Kennedy Griffin and Jocelyn Moore still to come. Haley Klein hits here. This is going to be a big rotation for Arkansas and is really going to give the Gymbacks an excellent chance to win the meet and certainly improve their NQS in the process. Lauren Williams, 9.8, still is the score that is dropped at the moment.
That was a side aerial layout step out you saw right there. Every week, Haley has just gotten better and better at this event. In her freshman season, really important for her confidence and the team's. Nicely done, round off 1.5 to the perfect stick. This acro series is difficult. Most athletes put their hand down on the hands, both hands, down on the beam for one part of the acro series. She does both in the flight position, no hands touching the beam, making it harder.
Haley's excited, but I don't think anybody is going to be more so than head coach Jordan Weaver taking over Beam this year, really working with them day in and day out, and put the meet together with a flourish on Beam. Can Missouri keep it close? Can they win? Kennedy Griffin and Jocelyn Moore to close out.
Stunning front through to double tuck. Nice stick coming out of that pass. Getting ready for this next tumbling pass here. Double pike, so same as her first pass, but in the pike position. Great control coming out of it.
Griffin needs to score at 9.925 or better just to keep Missouri in the meet. Excellent routine. She's got a chance to do just that.
Front through to double tuck. I love the way she stuck that. And having fun with her teammates.
She could be so good. She's already got five scores of 9.9 or better in seven collegiate floor routines, and she might have just had her sixth in eight tries. Serena Linton can add to this advantage for Arkansas. 197.75 at the moment is what Arkansas has, and that's with dropping the 9.8. Or for Lauren Williams, or counting the 9.8, that is. And if they can do better than that 9.8, it's going to go up even more. What can Serena Linton, the transfer, do?
Triple series. Excellent job. I also don't want to speed past her wolf double turn that you saw her do in the beginning of her routine. She struggled on that last week, nailed it today. All athletes have to do a full turn. She does too, making it more difficult.
If Serena scores a 9.85 on this routine, Arkansas wins the meet, puts together a massive score.
Small shuffle forward, tried to get the landing. It's gonna be a good score. We'll see if it's enough for Arkansas to get the win. Difficult triple series right here. Legs all the way extended throughout. Tried to hold on to it, fought for it. Just a small shuffle forward.
It's gonna be close. Is it all gonna come down to Jocelyn Moore though? Kennedy Griffin had a 9.95. So it certainly kept them in the meet. Serena Linton, a 9.9. Arkansas returns the favor. After Missouri got the win last year, it is the Gymbacks here with a record on Beam. Not only a season record, it is a program record on Beam.
Jocelyn's challenge from Coach Shannon Welker was to point her feet on her front through to double tuck. That was her biggest deduction and critique from Coach Shannon Welker. Trying to see if she can do that on this last pass right here. They were pointed, and I love the stick. That was impressive.
That's just an incredible way to close it out for Missouri. But it is going to be in vain, unfortunately, for the Tigers. But still, this is going to be a score that they're happy with. Remember, they needed better than a 197 to improve their NQS, and that's what they did.
Gigantic double layout to open Jocelyn's routine right there. And this is where he challenged her to point her feet. I see pointed feet in the air before she comes down to the floor, so I'm going to say she did it.
You're going to give it to her.
I'm giving it to her.
I would hope that the judges would as well. But, I mean, Arkansas is absolutely rolling right now. They're coming off a 197-4 where they set the school floor record. Well, today they not only set the beam school record, they set their overall single meet record with a 197.65. Kennedy, this is a very dangerous Jim Bax team that very clearly has a ton of confidence right now.
Absolutely, Alex. And each meet, they're just getting better and better, building off of their scores and their momentum each regular season meet to set themselves up for the postseason.
And what I love about gymnastics the most is the fact that not only does Arkansas set their program record, Missouri also puts together a 197.525, which is their season high, so they have something to be happy about as well. Kennedy and I will wrap it all up when we return on SEC Network. A meet that both of these teams are going to be ecstatic about. Arkansas setting a new program record with a 197.65. Missouri, though, very much improving their NQS with a 197.525. We are joined by one of the Jim Bax stars, Matty Jones. Matty, you guys put it all together today in a big way. This team seems like it's rolling down the hill towards the postseason. What was it like to compete out there and to set the new program record this season?
Oh, it's just been unbelievable. This team is incredible, and we've just been in the gym working hard every single week to be the team that we know we can be. And this is just a show, like, we're not done yet, and we're still ready for postseason.
Maddie, we talked with head coach Jordan Weber earlier this week, and she said you specifically have really stepped up this year, mentally and physically. How do you feel about your beam routine today?
I feel like it was a great beam routine just to reset. I had some trouble a few weeks ago, and I've just been back in the gym just gaining my confidence back, and today was just really great, and it was just what I do every day, and it was my normal, so it was a lot of fun.
That's awesome. And how is your team going to use this road win specifically for the postseason?
I think that we can use this road win. Just, we're at an away arena with a large crowd. It was really loud in here, and we can just take that to postseason and just use our confidence, and we lean on each other as a team and just bring it home.
Matty, last thing for you. I mean, it just seems like there's a different energy around this Jim Bax program right now. What is it about this year that has made the difference?
I think that we're just all connected as one. We are one big family, and we all have the exact same goal, and we're all locked in on that goal, and we just can't wait to achieve it, and we just keep working hard, and we're going to make it. So,
Matty, congratulations. Good luck down the stretch.
Thank you so much.
Kennedy, this was really impressive. I mean, Matty Jones competing in three different events, three 9925s.
And to hit so solidly on the road, Alex, has to be a great boost for her confidence as well as the team's. She's really just a rock star today.
And so Matty Jones finishing on floor again, 3.9925. This is going to be really important for Arkansas going into the postseason, because remember, they are trying to make the evening sessions of SECs and get to the top four in the SEC. This is certainly going to help them. Kennedy, final thoughts here at a great meet.
Yeah, it was a great competition for both teams. Arkansas really stepped up and delivered today, had a great showing of all four events. And then Missouri, little bit of a struggle, but honestly a great score, and they're going to use that energy going into SECs.
Exactly what both teams were looking for. Keep that momentum going as we close out the SEC regular season here in the Hearn Center, and we do it in style at bat. So with Kennedy Baker for our fantastic SEC Network crew, I'm Alex Perlman saying so long from Columbia, Missouri. It's a new program record for the Chipbacks.